Guys, and look at that.
Captain Falcon versus Roy, two extremely fast combo heavy character, lots of damage on both sides. So we're here to see a very fast paced match, and already both of these players off to their speedy starts. Look at that, the up air's coming out into the blast zone, and off you go. OG taking first blood in just 20 seconds.
Yes, exactly what we know Captain Falcon to do, get those strings going and be really, really scary. You know, you have to think though, both of these players representing the same team of LSE. They play each other. The up tilt off that string and the taunt. OG is here to play, making sure his teammate knows that he is not to be trifled with.
No frame wasted by OG, but here's Flo going for the offstage pressure. Gets dunked under the stage, sent to the blast zone. That game was a Twitch clip.
Oh man, that was like, it felt like less than a minute, but OG came out absolutely swinging that and just putting the feet onto his teammate. And getting back into these games without any major deficit kind of coming in his way. A little bit of a dash for backs and forward,
and here's the combo game. A lot of damage on OG already. That the read could have been it. The parry, the jab, no DI on that, but
right
the
idea.
Forward smash barely whiffed. A little bit off on execution, but it has to be a confident booster. Seeing that your reads are working out in Flo's favor right now. Such great bait movement here. Flo just moving backwards, constantly taking space if OG gives it to him. And it,
that should be it. Yeah. Absolutely, yeah. Ooh, oh, he's staying alive. Two center on stage, though.
Touching the blast zone just barely.
That is a big part of Roy's kind of finishes. You're going to be looking for those jabs into the back airs. But, wow.
That's big. He waited for Flo, and Flo, he was not going to give him the air dodge. Instead, OG calling that and just immediately going for the back air.
And foiled a little bit at the start, but just consistently keeping that one going to push it as far as possible.
I mean, even the beginning of that edge guard was just to push Pew further off stage. Ooh. He kept pushing Pew, forcing him to take it wide, and that gave him the opportunity for the back air. Two frames
with a forward smash. You don't often see it, but there it is. So much great edge guarding coming out. Oh, there it is once again. Unbelievable.
Game one over Pew. 1-0 for our Bayonetta player here. Playing for loser round 5. Winner gets 5th.
And you're clearly just showing he's just not afraid, to push it to the absolute loot limits. And you need to do that to get these really quality and sometimes game-changing edge guards.
He's utilizing the maximum potential of that Bayonetta recovery for sure, Bowie. And this is one of the benefits of playing the same character as you did in Smash 4. You were intimately aware of their limits. Mm-hmm. There's the aerial afterburner kick again into the Witch Time forward smash, just pushing Pew all the way to the edge, into the corner, and that is another one of those aerial afterburner kicks. The hitbox is just so great. It can beat a lot of moves.
And
up smash.
Smash as well going to be, and Mies just absolutely removed, erased from the screen there as the up smash just sent him flying.
There's the down tilt into the boomerang tech chase, but Leffen breaking through and just trying to get the platform pressure. Good out of shield options as well. And we can see Young Link's range coming to his advantage, but the damage output by Squirtle is just a little bit too much right here for Mr. R.
Squirtle is a dangerous character. We've seen a lot of that combo work, and Leffen is just so deadly with
it. Mr. R, the jump, there it is, but it gets intercepted. No jump on Mr. R. The downer is not going to connect, and now it's Ivysaur versus Young Link, and this is a bad look.
Using the Pokemon change just there to evade that forward air coming in. You could feel that one. And of course, that Pokemon change having invulnerability from frame one.
The reaction to the spot dodge. Nice up smash, as you were mentioning, Bowie. Sorry for interrupting. And one of the things that you have to mention about Pokemon Switch, yes, it is invincible. Yes, it gets you out of bad scenarios, but because you're drifting in the air, it does mean that you're still in a bad scenario in the start. But Mr. R making an SD happen.
Yeah, an air dodge came out. I think he was just expecting himself to have a little bit more ability to move around that.
It's very, very well. Going high as well, just reacting to what Mr. R is doing, realizing,
it's back air is coming out so much, just doing
walling.
So much work.
Lots of walling right there. And you have to play this way with Ivysaur, because Ivysaur's long range game is not strong enough to match Young Link's.
You have to play how you need to win. I mean, it doesn't really matter. But nice dash attack just connecting there. Not going to be taking that stock. Again, Young Link struggling to find very specific types of setups for those KOs.
Oh.
There's the back air into the charge. F smash to just cover.
Into the up, into the nair. There's no recovering for Young Link. Maybe with the bomb, but
it wasn't enough.
And Leffen leading the setup with a 3-stock right there. What a statement, Mr. R. And here comes Krom fighting versus Squirtle. This is the hardest matchup of the three, but a decent read will end that Squirtle stock extremely early. There's the up out of shield. Nice awareness off his options. Nice awareness of the cross-up. No punish on the withdraw.
Yeah, gets that grab as well, looking to press the advantage. And the withdraw comes out. It's working so nicely. The armor on that being just insane.
Oh, and here comes the Gimp attempt.
Oh, another.
And Mr. R, another SD. It's very hard to get past him when he has you cornered. Look at that. Another parry by Space and the finisher getting the grab on the platform of all things. Plus the ink is going to extend that upper window. Extremely, extremely well done by Space.
First stock going down within the first minute there of this game, and then looking pretty solid so far. Not too much percent, you know. It's one of those things, you know, I don't think Armada has played, you know, the Ditto against, you know, one of the other best, one, you know, the best Inklings out there, unless he did play Cosmos when he was in America. I'm not quite sure.
We're not quite sure, but it does show that Space is prepared here. He knows what he wants to do. We've seen him parry so many backers already, and he doesn't even have a big read on Armada yet. This is their first game together. They have not played friendlies yet. And even now, Space has already got a hang of the timing. He knows his own character so very well. Of course, Armada, no slouch either, has the corner scenario. Great reaction on the roll right there. Tries to get the follow-up, but gets a zone broken by that forward air Space has to offer.
A little bit too patient there on the edge, waiting and then getting hit by the splat bomb as it hits below the stage.
Space gets with the grab. No up air at these percentages, but the corner situation gets extended. Reads the roll with the jump back. Very excellent coverage. That was a soft read, knowing that even if he was wrong, he still had an advantageous position. Very smart.
There's a scoop up from the up smash. Going to be that first stock for Armada there.
To do with the scoop up smash right there.
Yeah, that's going to be another stock. So looking so good right now. But Space getting the first real interaction there of this final stock with the grab up air. And once again, another grab up throw up air will be connecting again and gets him, gets his opponent off stage right now. Splat bomb is low. Looking for that final splat.
There's the roll read into the KO. JV two stock and Space is the first Inkling to take a W for the Netherlands. A very small character, very good at gimping as well. Strong combo game versus that heavy fast faller that is Captain Falcon. This is going to be a lot of damage if Leffen executes correctly, but feels a little bit. Here comes the Lex trap, though.
Yeah, staying true, just keeping that space nice and just catching as much as he can. Look, again, almost 50% unanswered, but there's a first grab coming out from OG. The first bit of damage onto Leffen right now. The down tilt, I think, run up down tilt grab into the up throw.
Of course, it was a four tilt. It does look very similar. It is Squirtle, after all. That down tilt is going to be his main two-frame move, though. And there's another four throw, a double.
Very nice, beautiful
into
stuff.
Into forward tilt on the misstep, into a jab lock forward smash. That was Leffen playing 4D chess right there on OG's first stock.
Everything that you hit, whether it's a weak hit or a hard hit, is going to be a KO at higher percents or mid percents.
Yeah, you need to respect that move, and that forces you to play a lot differently, a lot more defensively. And in this scenario, will Armada be able to make an adjustment? Will he be able to realize the aspects missing of his gameplay? Right now, he is looking pretty solid, but don't forget, last game was exactly the same. He kept it very even, but it was the moments that Rage got those big hits that really come in big. He gets the tech chase, not quite, but he does chase Rage down into the up throw up air, and Armada with a strong lead right here in game number two.
Yeah, as you're saying, doesn't miss those, and he obviously clearly didn't. Connecting another one.
I still believe it was a good choice because he wasn't feeling confident in Krom right there. But I feel like in this scenario, he does feel more confident than Krom.
Up throw. I'm up air just did 21.1% with that ink on. Jeez. That's a lot of damage. Right, okay. Just trying to find that follow-up, but nice get-up attack to punish that one back. Up throw, up air once more. Not going to be taking it just yet. Getting closer to that percentage, though.
Yep, Mr. R just chilling on the platform, making his way to neutral when Space gives him the room. Baiting out the grab, Space really looks for those. He's moving left and right, looking for those grabs. And now he got the back air. He knows he has another way to get the KO, and that is the Gimp situation. There's the run-up down tilt, very well found right there, and the bomb is going to limit the options.
Oh, and there's
make
punish
the
as well.
Forward air easy on him, and that is a easy stock for Space. Pull out here to mix up his opponents.
And he's able to getting rid of those extra platforms as well, just to make it a little bit more linear. Take away the devastation that Space can cause by utilizing the platforms just even more, and giving himself just one if he needs to use it. that game.
An attempted interception by Mr. R. A little bit of a whiff is going to get punished here. It's space. Looking for the back of the strings, but Mr. R. Pretty rough for him to find his foothold, even if he is ahead in percent. It's not for long.
Okay. Got out of that one just enough. Okay, getting caught by the get-up attack as well. Loads of aggression, but, you know, get-up attack is one of the...
Yep. Go ahead.
And all I was just going to say, like, get-up attack is one of those options that people always seem a little bit unaware of, and the roller coming out, taking that first stock there as well.
Yep. Space on a roll here. 2-1 lead, gets the roller as well. There's the neutral B. Mr. R, he reacted to the roll, but he was a little bit too slow. And there's the forward tilt, just swinging left and swinging right, getting all the decisive hits. And that hit is the most decisive. It is an even game right now. Mr. R looking a lot better than the previous game already.
Yeah, getting really, really far in there as well. You know, jumping up with space to get that up air. Nice stuff from him. Jab, combo comes out.
A shield? Nope, a landing up air even. An amazing combo starter. And this is what could have happened if space didn't answer back in the last game. 50% and a corner scenario. Mr. R keeps the pressure up. This is one landing up air, ladies and gentlemen. This is how far the top level can push that. 92% on space. Into the parry. Into the jump back air. That's a 0-2 death, Mr. R. Mr. R, knowing his percents, space, just coming up a little bit short, and that should bite him in the behind soon.
Oh, but there is going to be the roller.
Barely.
Yeah.
And that was a great read, once again, on Mr. R's defensive options. Space has a good read on what Mr. R wants to do to, you know, avoid those grabs. Goes for the roller instead. A nice 50-50 right there. There's the back air, gets parried into the weight on the air dodge, but no reaction, no hit on the forward smash either. And this might be Space's break. This might be the opportunity that he needed to take this game back in his hands. But Mr. R, look at that. Ooh, he misses.
Yeah, a slight input seemed a little bit off. Got the kind of right idea, but a little bit wayward.
The down smash on the... He misses. He gets dragged down by the vortex of B. The soaring slash just dragging the Inkling into the depths. And that is Mr. R making it happen. 2-2 for these two Dutch competitors, but only one can make it to Grand Finals. Will it be Space?
Looking for the next big moment here. Gets the grab into the surf quite easily there.
Air dodge utilizing the double jump to kind of mix up the height as well. Forward tilt one, forward tilt two. No further pressure, but does intercept the jump. Mr. R keeps jumping to get out of the corner. There's another tech chase. Missed. And the Ivy Star just barely not getting the follow-up hit.
It's looking scary right now for Mr. R, though. He cannot get any hits right now on left, and he's just playing so well. His spacing is so clean.
Oh, there was the up B.
That thing,
Mr. R.
Okay, there's the jump, so he's still alive.
Woohoo! Leffen at the read. Mr. R did not have the reaction, but he can count his blessings because Leffen messing that up just barely. It is a one-frame window, as we discussed before, right? There's Charizard, the scary, scary big boy.
Yeah, oh, again, we've seen him do these up smashes so well and so consistently. Got to be careful right now if you're Mr. R. This is a scary position you don't want to be above. Gets a run up, tries to get that grab. The back end's going to be it, and it's three stocks to one.
Whiffs twice in a row.
This is Mr. R's tournament stock. Everything is on this. There's a jab back air, takes one stock back. He's got a lot to do. He's got two stocks to get rid of from Leffen right now. What can he do? Landing up air into turnaround, forward tilt for the grab, the combos. This is a percentage you do not want to be taking in Grand Finals on your last stock.
You can see Mr. R being a little bit shaky. He's rolling. He's not normally rolling. He's really trying to avoid that edge because those early kills will be the death of him. And he knows Leffen has two stocks. He can go as deep as he wants to close it out. Let's see how they play the neutral. Mr. R looking for grabs. He's playing it slow. He's playing around the shield because Leffen, he's relying on shield.
He's relying on
Squirtle. And Squirtle just died to that forward smash read. That's Mr. R at his finest.
That's absolutely exactly what he wanted. You know, getting that hit there, getting the air dodge in.
Okay, Mr. R, the landing downer. The continuation as well, 40% on Charizard all the way back to Squirtle. This tech chase did not connect because of the random turnaround.
But this is what we wanted to see. You know, Mr. R coming all the way back, bringing it back down to a last of stock scenario, 67%. This is doable. He needs to get off that turtle. I know he wants to stay on it, but it's just too light. It's too fragile at the scenario.
Tech chase, no combo, but the follow-up, the back throw with the poor DI. Here goes Charizard, the flamethrower intercepting again, but no follow-up. The jump over.
On the back edge. really good jump to keep that space open so he couldn't get the up smash. Looking scary right now, but anyone can win this game. Is it just going to be a
fall? There it is! That's it!
Leffen proves his worth! He proves his mettle, resets the bracket, and 3-2 defeats Mr. R. He's waited all year to come out to a tournament and prove what he's capable of, and he's done it once again. TSM Leffen, your DreamHack Winter 2019 champion.